this is the theorem number one. Let equation ax square plus 2hxy plus by square equal to 0 represents pair of statements. Whenever you find this statement in the question, theorem means you don't have any numbers in this, that's why it is represented to be a theorem. What they have given, if equation of the kind represent pair of straight lines, this represents pair of straight lines to given to us. So we have to consider left ax square plus 2hxy. Straight lines, that is L1x plus M1y equal to 0 and L2x plus M2y equal to 0. How many lines we have to consider? Two lines without constant. Why without constant? Because this pair of line passes through origin. Whatever lines which passes through origin does not have any constant. See, L1x plus M1y plus N1 I am not taking here. So always for this one you have to remember the statement one. Let ax square plus 2hx square plus by square equal to 0 represents a pair of straight lines, that is L1x plus M1y equal to 0 and L2x plus M2y equal to 0. These are two lines. This implies whatever lines they have given, this represents two lines actually. So that equation should be equated with these two lines. Now we have to multiply. How to multiply this? L1x into M2y plus M1y into M2x plus M2y. Those who are good at simplification, they can easily get this one. We are multiplying these two. L1 and 2, then x square. First we have to multiply the coefficients. Then yx or x
plus
m1 m2 y. Now is there any common we find here?
Yes,
m1 m2 xy we find common. Step 1. Always whenever you find ax square plus 2hxy plus by square equals to 0, what we have to write in the proof? Let ax square plus 2hxy plus by square equal to 0 represents pair of straight lines, that is, see, this line is not a single line. This is pair of line, means it has two lines in it. So what we have to do, that line, whatever we have considered, whatever given, we have to consider two multiples, brackets. Then multiply both of them. How to multiply? First term with the whole bracket, then second term with the whole bracket. After multiplying, we find xy common. We have taken xy common. For every question, when ax square plus 2hxy plus by square is given to you, we'll follow the same step. Then we'll compare, comparing on both sides. See, at the time we are comparing both sides, x square cancelled, a is equals to L1 L2. Then xy cancelled. What remains here? 2h is equals to
L1 M2 plus M1 L2.
Then y square
cancelled.
M1 L2. This is our first step completed now. Theta equals to angle between lines. Cos theta formula you should remember. A1 square plus B1 square into root over A2 square plus B2 square. This is the general formula to find angle between the lines as we have done in straight lines. Long back in videos you might find that formula. Angle between the lines formula is cos theta equals to a1 a2 plus b1 b2 by root over a1 square plus b1 square into root over a2 square plus b2 square. Which formula? Cos theta formula is this one. But we need cos theta of this formula. So what we have to do? This a1 b1. So we have two lines, l1x plus m1y equal to 0, l2x plus m2y equal to 0. This is a1 b1 and a2 b2. Now we are substituting cos theta equals to a1 a2 plus b1 b2 by root over a1 square plus b1 square into root over a2 square plus b2 square. Now this one as it is, actually L1 L2 is A and L1 L2 is B, A plus B we got it anyhow, but we are not substituting now as it is I am writing. Here both the values are under root, so single root we have to consider and multiply first one with first value, first one with second value plus second one with first value plus second one with second value. When you find these four terms anywhere, L1, L2, L1, L2, M1, L2, M1, M2, we have to add and subtract 2 L1, L2, M1, M2 and subtract 2 L1, L2, M1, M2. Plus and minus we have to take from our side. When we will consider that one? When you find L1, L2 with squares, L1, L2 with squares. If these four terms are there, in the next problem also, if I ask these four terms are there, what you should add and subtract? 2 L1 L2 M1 L2. What is the use of them? Check this. This one and this. Three things. If I consider that first tick as A square, both terms are A. L1 L2 is A. This is B. A square plus B square, then this will be
minus 2
AB.
So what we can write?
A minus B
whole square. Then remaining thing. This is A square plus B square plus 2 AB.
A.
Whatever A value plus B. Or best thing, you can by hat these two formulas. Now substitute the values. Cos theta here on left side, cos theta carry down, this is A plus this is B by root over this one again A minus B whole square plus this value is how much? L1 M2. Yes, L1 M2 plus M1 L2 is 2H. 2H whole square is?
4H
is square. Hence 2. What we have done, check this one. Let equation is given to us. So whenever that equation is given, we will write that ax square plus 2hxy plus by square equals to 0 represents pair of lines l1x plus m1y equal to 0 and l2x plus m2y equal to 0. That implies ax square plus 2hxy plus by square equals to l1x plus m1y into l2x plus m2y. Then we have to multiply l1x with m2x plus m2y. Then we have again we have to multiply L1y with L2x plus M2y. Then multiply, compare that one, A, H and B will get. What we have to do? We have to find angle between lines. We have to show that one. So you have to use the formula of cos theta equals to L1 M2 plus M1 L2 divided by
A1 square.
Yes, L1 A1 square plus B1 square into A2 square plus B2 in terms of A1 and B1. Then we have to substitute A1, B1 and A2, B2 from these two considered lines from our side. This we have considered, na? At the end, whatever you will get this value. Then after multiplication, you should remember plus 2 L1 and 2, that value. Thank you. this question, what is given to us like this? We find this line. So what we will do when we find this line? We will consider that ax square plus 2hx square plus by square equal to 0 represent pair of lines L1x plus L1y equal to 0 and M2x plus M2y equal to 0. Then ax square plus 2hx square plus by square equal to both lines in brackets and multiplied. After multiplying, taking xy common, then comparing both sides, we'll get a is equal to L1 L2, 2h equals to L1 M2 plus M1 L2, and b is equal to M1 M2. Once we got these things, after comparison we got this, now we have to come to the question, what they have given? Perpendicular distances product. Product of perpendicular distances from alpha, beta to pair of lines. What is the meaning of perpendicular distance? Suppose there is a line, suppose we have two lines, right? We have one point from where we have perpendicular distance, here also we have perpendicular distance. Suppose this is D1 and D2. So what we have to show? We have to show that D1, D2, their product is this value. So we have to find perpendicular distances from alpha beta to the lines they have given. So one formula you have to remember from this. Previous theorem, what formula you have to remember? Cos theta equals to a1 a2 plus b1 b2 by root over a1 square plus b1 square into root over a2 square plus b2 square. For this one, you have to remember that d1 is equals to perpendicular distance from, what is the point they have given? Alpha, beta to pair of lines. So first line I am taking as L1x plus M1y equal to 0. Formula to find perpendicular distances, ax1 plus by1 plus c by root of a square plus b square. So from where we will get x1, y1? This point is x1, y1. These are a, b. C is not there. So what you will get here? ax1, l1 alpha plus by1. m1 is b, then y1 is beta. C is not there. By root over a square. L1 square plus B square, M1 square. Then second D2. D2 is also perpendicular distance from alpha comma beta to the line. Line 2 now. L2x plus M2y equals to 0. Formula is already there. I will not write formula. I will write the value. AX1. This is X1, Y1. These are AB values. A is L2. Alpha plus beta. Now, what we got? D1, D2 we got, right?
Yes.
D1 means perpendicular distance from alpha beta to line 1. D2 means again perpendicular distance from alpha beta to line 2. Once we have perpendicular distance, what they have given? Product of perpendicular distances from this. So D1, D2 is there. Now we have to write product of perpendicular distances. Product of perpendicular distances. D1, D2. Into. In the previous theorem, we have divided, multiplied the denominator. The same thing we will do here also. But numerator is extra thing we got here. These two multiplication modulus. L1 alpha is multiplied to both. So first we multiply L1 L2 alpha square plus M1 L2
beta.
Alpha beta plus this one is multiplied to first one. First to first, first to second. Second to first. Second to second. Note again. Divided by what? These two, under root na, single root. First is multiplied to first. First one is multiplied to second.
L1 square, M2 square.
second one is multiplied to first. Plus second one is multiplied to second. Plus what I told you to remember. When we are adding and subtracting means we can do that one, so any problem. Now for these four terms are there, we have considered fifth and sixth term along with that. Now in numerator what we got? L1 L2 alpha square plus anything common here? This one as it is only common thing I have taken modulus is there. Root over. What I told you to remember, if these things are there. Or how to remember, check here. A minus B is there, now we have A minus B. So you can simply copy down that A minus B works here. Then second one will be? This one. L M2 plus M1 2 works here. L1 M2 and these three will go, you will get this whole square. Now substitute the value, therefore perpendicular distances equals to A alpha square plus alpha beta into this is 2h plus B beta square by B, because M1 M2 is B na?
Yes.
B beta square by root over A minus B whole square. Plus 4h squared. Okay. One is most important of all theorems, expected one for final exam. Quite lengthy also. By the lines ax square plus 2hxy plus by square. See, this is origin and these are pair of lines. This one represent these two lines, 1 and 2. And the line, this line, 3, they are forming one triangle or not?
Yes.
So we have to find that area formed by 2 lines. Now, when we find this line, what we will do? Ax square plus 2hxy plus dy square equal to 0 represent pair of lines. That is L1x plus M1y equal to 0 and L2x plus M2y equal to 0 implies multiply both of them, compared, we got A, 2h and B. Now given lines we have. Sides of triangle, how many sides are there? 3, no? 1, 2, 3. First one is L1x plus M1y plus 0 equal to 0. Second one, L2x plus M2y, we don't have constant, so you can take 0. First line, second line and third line you can say. Plus M equals. It has constant whereas other doesn't have constant. Why they doesn't have constant? Whatever lines which are passing through origin does not have any constant to it. And the line is not passing through origin. That's why it has constant N. Now what we have to do? When we have this thing, 1 and 2 is origin. What we will do here, check it out. Solve name. 1 and 2. y 0 comma 0?
Y 0.
Yeah, first and second equation does not have constants. If you solve them, you will get 0 comma 0. If you are interested, you can solve. Now I will take this one as A and this one as B. So solving A, na, you can check the points where they goes. Solving 1 and 3 per A. How to solve 1 and 3? Check this. 1 and 3. Second term, third term, first term, second term. Third equation, second term, third term, first term, and second term. Don't take x, y values. Second, third, BCAB form. Then x, y, and 1. X divided by AD. Minus BC. Y by AD. Minus BC. 1 by AD. BC. Wherever numbers are there, right there. Where numbers are not there, no need. Now this x equals to. This goes to the numerator. And y equals to. This goes to the numerator. Minus NL1. If you ignore the minus sign, then everything becomes wrong. Therefore, we got A. L1N by L1N minus LN1. Minus NL1 by L1M minus LN1. What we did after getting this one? In the first theorem, we have taken cos theta is equals to angle between theta equals to angle between the lines. Cos theta equals to A1 A2 plus B1 B2 by root over A1 square plus B1 square into root over A2 square plus B2 square. In the second theorem, we have, clear we did, we have perpendicular distances. So D1 is equals to perpendicular distance from the point to the line. Then we have one formula substituted for D2 also we got in the same way. What's that way? Ax1 plus by 1 plus C by root of A square plus B square. Then we found perpendicular distance product. Then we got the answer here. Why I am finding this one? Whenever triangle is given to you, you have tried all the sides, equations of the sides. Sides of triangle. These are equations of sides of triangle. Solving 1 and 2, origin is there. So without solving, you can write 0, 0. 1 and 3 is A. 3 and 2 is B. 1 and 3 we have solved. We got A. Solving. Similarly, I am writing. Solving 2 and 3. What is B? Tell me directly. What is B? What is the difference between first equation and third? First and second, second and third equation. Yes, first and third we have solved. Same thing. Second and third also without solving you can write that.
Yes.
L1 is removed as L2 and M1 is replaced as M2. Here M1 I am replacing as M2.
L2M by L2M minus LM2.
Just wherever one is there, we can write
L2 by L2M minus LM2.
So these are the points we got. Once we got the points, area of triangle, if one point is origin, short formula. Actually formula is big, x1 y2 minus y3 plus x2 y3 minus this one, na? Half mod x1 y2 minus y3 plus x2 y3 minus y1 plus x3 y1 minus y2. Okay, now x3 y3 is origin, this is origin, this is origin, this is origin. Okay, now what I will get, half mod x1 y2 plus plus into minus minus x2 y1, 0 and anything is?
0.
The formula becomes short. So what you have to do? Whenever origin is given to you, area of triangle is half x1 y2 plus x2 y1. Half modulus. What is x1? X1 and y1 is this one. X1, y1. These two are x2, y2. So x1, y2. X1 you can tell me? Tongue twister is there, so you can be very aware, write brackets into y2.
minus
then this minus x2
minus
minus is this formula minus sign.
Yes.
Y1.
Minus L1
L1 okay. Modulus closed. 1 by 2, these two I have multiplied. So minus n into n is n square m1 l2. Minus into minus is plus. N into n is n square.
M1.
M to L1 you want to write? You can write. By these two denominators are same, I am writing single denominator. Most important one, what we have done, x1 y2 minus x2 y1, these two denominators are same, single denominator, multiplied written here and minus into minus plus, remaining thing we have written here. Now we are taking n square common in the numerator and I am writing positive term first. By multiplying these two, minus second L1 L2 M square, then L1 M2, first 1 and 2 terms we write, L1 M2, then M into L Ln, then second term with first term, you can write numbers first, M1 L2. Ln. Then
plus
last one minus into minus plus L square. Yes. Now, in answer, what we find here in numerator, no talking?
N square.
And root is there. Okay. After n square, we have to write this one in root. So, what we will do? Whenever a minus b is there, if I want to write a minus b in root, I have to write a plus b whole square minus 4ab. What is the formula we have to use? See, a minus b. I am replacing this a minus b into this form. So, half into modulus into n square, I am removing this a minus b, root over a plus b whole square. What is a plus b?
M2
L1 plus M2. M1 L2 whole square minus 4ab. A is M2 L1, M1 L2.
Sir,
M2
first one sir, M2 L1. N square ke baad, N square ke baad.
M2
sir,
up N2. M2 L1 plus M1 L2 divided by?
Same
but we will take common here, L1 L2 into M square minus Ln
common. L1 M2
plus Y plus sign, no talking. Now we can conclude this. How to conclude this? 1 by 2 n square as it is, root over, this is which value? 2h. This is 2h, L1 M2 plus M1 L2 is 2h. 2h is whole square, 4h square. 4 into L1 L2 M1 L2, AB divided by A m square, Ln into 2h plus
b
l square or l square b. Now this 4 comes out, after taking 4 common and outside it becomes 2. Why it becomes 2? 4 is common, is under root.
Yes.
So it becomes 2 outside. So h square minus ab by a m square minus 2HLM
plus 2L square.
Hence 2. This is area of triangle, which is your expected question for a final exam.